Does the United States believe that Serbia is the major geostrategic factor as a part of the Balkans here?
Well, you know, I can tell you that President Trump was really excited with the historic agreement that was made between the Balkans and Serbia, you know, again, in the Oval Office, to continue to show our strength and support to Serbia and our involvement in your region. And so, again, it is a top priority to make sure that Kosovo and Serbia deal do move forward, especially as President Trump prepares to win the second election. As you can see, we are really wide open here, going from state to state to state. This will be our fifth stop today. And so we, you know, the president is working hard to secure the historic agreement that took place in the Oval Office and to make sure that, you know, he wins the second term and we uphold the commitments to Serbia and to the Balkans.
The Washington Agreement was a huge success, and it is a part of the bigger idea of creating mini Schengen regional idea, which is one of the biggest peace initiatives of President Trump. Besides this Washington Agreement, also the peace agreement for Middle East. So is that the new policy that we can expect in the second term from President Trump? Peace initiatives all around the world with strengthening economic ties between countries, such as mini Schengen zone, in which Serbia, Albania, Macedonia, Kosovo, also Bosnia and Herzegovina and Montenegro should work closely to tighten these economic reforms and communication.
Well, I can't speak on the behalf of the administration, but I can tell you, I know President Trump personally, his heart is to, again, strengthen the ties of all of our allies, and that includes Serbia, that includes the Balkan region, and, you know, that includes Kosovo. We want to make sure that, you know, the any mishaps that are still taking place behind the scenes end so that we can have economic prosperity for all in the region. And again, a stronger Balkan region is a stronger America. I think I said that before. And it's important that we, the United States and President Trump will continue to enforce that. Right now, it is very challenging to say what we can and can't do other than right now is to win the re-election, make sure that Joe Biden is not elected. And we believe that the president is going to have a massive win here in a couple of hours here in America as we are winding down, you know, the final day of the campaign.
Which the United States can offer Serbia more than Russia or China, let's say?
Well, you know, I can tell you that it's been clear that the president and this administration is to combat and compete against Russia and against China and any other countries that are infiltrating, like in Africa, infiltrating their influence. We would obviously rather be the influencer and to have our key partners in the region of the Balkans to continue to make Americans' presence and interests known. Again, I'm going to keep echoing what the president's made very clear. A stronger Balkan, a stronger Kosovo, a stronger Serbia is a stronger America. A stronger NATO is a stronger America. A stronger America is a strong NATO.
Carpenter is advisor in the headquarters of Democratic presidential candidate, and he says that the focus of Biden's strategy for Serbia is entry into European Union, support for further reforms in the field of rule of law, etc., etc., and ties between Serbia and United States, stronger ties in terms of travel, investments, and strengthening military relations between the two countries. What is the focus of Trump's strategy for Serbia?
Well, I can just tell you the structure for the president has always been number one, America first. Any allies in like Serbia that's going to strengthen the economic stronghold in America is a top priority. Investments coming to America, but in reverse, investments coming back into Serbia. I can tell you this, we're using the CARES Act, excuse me, not the CARES Act, but the BILLS Act to influence and combat Russia and China's influence in Africa. So just like the BILLS Act, which is placing U.S. investments in Africa, placing U.S. Investors into Africa, That's a top priority for the president. Right now, we're in the middle of a major, major deal right now with the country of Kenya to make sure that we are removing Russia and removing China's influences in those regions. So just like in Africa, it is a top priority for the president, I can tell you, to make sure that our key partners in Serbia, key partners in the Balkan regions, we strengthen those bonds. We got to be stronger. That would ultimately create more jobs for both sides.
Well, one of those steps, we're opening the headquarters of DFC in Belgrade, according to the Washington Agreement. That was the first step. And I suppose that there will be other quick warp steps that the United States will take after the elections. What is your message to the Serbs that are living in America, a message to the Serbian community?
Well, it is clear that President Trump has done a historic agreement with Kosovo and Serbia, and that he cares, his administration cares wholeheartedly for the home country of Northern Serbia and Serbia. So we need all Serbians in America, in Ohio, in North Carolina, the few that are in North Carolina, those in Pennsylvania, and those that are living in Florida, the few that are in Florida, go and vote Donald Trump. This president is a strong president who is all about creating economic strongholds between our two countries. He's made that very clear in the Washington Agreement back in September of this year. And so this is why we need to make sure, whatever you are in America, if you are an American and you love this great country, no matter where you was born, whether it's an African-American or a Serbian-American, go and vote Donald Trump so that he can continue the agreements that has taken place in D.C. and continue to bring peace and prosperity to both countries and all our partners in NATO. That is our number one focus, is that we defeat the lies of the mainstream media, continue to build the prosperity of this country, bring jobs back to America, strengthening our borders and strengthening the relationships with our allies, such as Serbia and those in the Balkan areas. And so that's right now top priority. But I can tell you, President Trump loves Serbia. President Trump loves the Serbians in America. They are our family. We need them. We need their support. And he needs their support. God bless you.
What are your expectations of the voting, of the results? What do you expect?
It's a landslide. It's going to be a massive landslide. We did this, even though I don't care what the polls are saying in other parts of the world, here in America. This is exactly what took place in 2016, with Hillary Clinton expected to be the first woman president of the United States of America. Clearly, the American people spoken. They didn't want crooked Hillary, and they most definitely don't want crooked Joe Biden to be their president. They want a strong president, a president that puts American interests first and strengthening our allies and economic prosperity for all countries. Again, we want prosperity for everyone. And President Trump is making sure of that. So please get out and vote. It's going to be a landslide, though. It's not going to be close.
Tonight we have another terrorist attack in Europe. It was in Vienna. At least 7 people are killed, and the police is searching for the attackers. We have spoken about the terrorist attacks in France also. Could you send a message from American administration to Europe in terms of condemning these terrorist attacks and support of European leaders?
Well, you know, President Trump is, again, he is the strongest president, the strongest leader we have ever had that has combat terrorism. He has made it very clear that he would use the might of the entire United States Army to hunt down any enemies of the United States of America, the authors of terrorism and our allies. And I can say this much, with the killing of Soleimani, General Soleimani, how President Trump moved swiftly to eliminate this author of destruction and terrorism against American and American allies, President Trump is without question the strongest president that we've ever had. And it is important that any and all allies who are under terrorist attack know that you want President Trump to remain the 45th president of the United States of America. You do not want a weak Joe Biden. You do not want a weak former President Barack Obama, because, again, an election of Joe Biden is a continuation of weak President Barack, former President Barack Obama, and we cannot have that. We can't go backwards, but only forward.
I think that you are aware of the fact that Serbia is a European leader in terms of economy, but United States have increased of the GDP in 33% in the last quarter. What is the recipe of such a fascinating results that Serbia can use?
Well, you know, the biggest thing, and again, I'm going to go back to President Trump. I mean, President Trump has made a strong commitment to the Balkan area. He's made a strong commitment to Serbia, that when he wins this second term, he's going to continue the support of the Serbian people, the Serbian government, and the magnificent thing that you guys are doing in European, in the European Union. And again, to strengthening the economic strongholds of all of our allies. I'm extremely proud of our Serbian Americans, and I know President Trump is too. And I can't wait to come to Serbia. You have to make sure that I get to come and be there. I was invited once before, but we couldn't work out the schedules, but I desperately want to come. So you got to make sure that I'm one of the first pastors, Black pastors, who loves this country, who loves President Trump, and to come to Serbia. So you tell your leaders to bring Pastor Burns to Serbia as soon as possible.
Thank you for this interview.
God bless you. Thank you all. God bless Serbia. God bless the United States of America.